For farmers to make a living, they must take risks, investing large sums of money, mostly worth of seeds, fertilizers, herbicides, and hoping for rain, but not too much of it though. Farming is risky. One does not know what the outcome will be when a crop is planted, and there is always a chance that a portion of the crop could be lost. To make matters worse, flooding, pest infestation, and increasing competition for arable lands, together with today's economy, are making it difficult for our farmers. As a result, most farmers resort to dangerous chemicals and bad practices in order to keep up with the growing demand for food. Some of these techniques used today for production of food are having negative effects on the environment, and concerned people are clamoring for organic foods and other ways to sustain rather than destroy the environment. For the purpose of this video, we will focus on techniques which can be taken to modernize farming and reduce losses of farmers' crops. These problems can be resolved by the implementation of the following advanced agricultural production techniques: hydroponic systems, genetic engineering, greenhouses, and aquaponics. Hydroponics. Hydroponics is the soilless growing technology where water is a medium for plants growing in a combination of nutrients and water. Growing plants hydroponically has several advantages, as it has the potential to increase fruit size as well as yield, resulting into maximum growth rates. Plants grow faster and mature larger because water and nutrients are constantly available for uptake. Hydroponically grown plants are normally grown inside, keeping them safe from insects and diseases. Also, it is a cost-effective and efficient method for small gardener and farmers too. With hydroponics, there is no need for a shovel, hoe, or plow for planting and harvesting crops. There are six types of hydroponic systems: wick system, water culture system, drip system, flow and drain hydroponic system, the nutrient film technique system, the aeroponic system. Here we have a nutrient film technique hydroponic system set up at the residence of a Barrack 4 farmer, Taran Rambasad. The nutrient film technique hydroponic system. In this system, plants are suspended in a tree or gutter over the nutrient solution, separating it from the nutrient reservoir with only their roots suspended inside it. The tree is set up at a sloped angle to encourage the flow of water. A pump delivers a continuous flow of water at higher raised end, creating a constant stream of nutrient solution in the bottom of the tree. In order to make sure the water flowing through the bottom of the tree is nice and even, a layer of absorbent material called capillary mat is placed in the bottom. Some advantages of hydroponics: less growing time is required, less infection possibilities, greater control over pest, weed, and disease, smaller spaces required for growing. Some disadvantages of hydroponics: rather high initial setup cost, growers require basic knowledge and skill to maintain successful results. Since in a hydroponic system, all plants share the same nutrient, diseases can spread like wildfire. In summary, hydroponic systems is a wonderful agriculture method to be adopted by the people of Trinidad and Tobago. It has provided better yield and less losses of produce for farmers while keeping production costs at a minimum. We would highly recommend hydroponic systems to farmers to face acts of gods, whether it be flooding, pest infestation, or other harmful effects, because of its isolation of the ground and a special chemical solution geared towards growing crops. Genetic engineering is the manipulation of DNA. In genetic engineering, genetic code is either altered artificially or genes are taken out of the DNA of one organism and inserted into the DNA of another organism. Transgenic plants is the terminology used for implementing techniques of genetic engineering to modify plant species. The genetic modification of foods can be used to increase their medicinal value, thus making homegrown edible vaccines available. Transgenic plants are also created to be resistant to weeds, herbicides, insects, and virus, which lower the need to use chemicals that eventually will have the adverse effect on the environment and ecosystems. Bringing genetic engineered food to the market is a lengthy and costly process, and agriculture biotech companies wish to ensure profitable return on their investment. Genetic engineering of plants has the potential of helping eradicate hunger, malnutrition, and effectively increase production of agricultural sectors. In order to use this method of production effectively, mankind must embark on more research in order to prevent any epidemic or agricultural catastrophes that may plague us if we become too enthusiastic and disrupt the equilibrium of the environment and diverse ecosystems. Greenhouse farming is a method that farmers use for cultivation of plants inside a building with glass walls or a roof under a controlled condition. Greenhouses protect against harsh weather conditions and fight against pests. With an appropriately designed greenhouse, this can bring an end to scorching of crops in the dry season and drenching of crops in the rainy season, or even pest infestations. Benefits of greenhouses: flexibility and time. Greenhouses allow you to control the temperature and humidity, a manipulation that allows you to grow vegetables year-round. In this closed microcosm, you can mimic the climate of any section of the world. There is more control of the climate, leading to better crops and extended growing seasons. In Trinidad and Tobago, greenhouse farming methods should be implemented more. To avoid crop loss from harsh weather conditions, it will produce healthier crops and also prevent harm from pests. In conclusion, greenhouses are a wonderful way to extend our vegetable growing seasons in Trinidad and Tobago. Since the function of the greenhouse is to create warm, humid environment to grow plants of tropical origin either year-round or to start the plants earlier, thus our climate is perfect and would be a great success. No more floods washing away our livelihood, no more hot sun shriveling up our crops. We endorse that farmers consider this use of farming in Trinidad and Tobago. This is basically a self-sustaining eco and environment-friendly system. This is highly effective organic gardening system which makes plant grow faster and allows you to grow 10 times more plants in the same space. An aquaponics system is a result of combining hydroponics and aquaculture to overcome the limitations in hydroponic gardening. Fish naturally produce ammonia, algae, minerals, and nitrates, all of which are required by plants to grow healthy. By connecting fish water with hydroponic water, plants get the nutrients and purify the water for the fish. The fish waste does not have to be discarded into the environment, but instead treated and recycled. To achieve efficiency, there must be harmony. Therefore, if any chemicals or heavy metals are added to the plants, the fishes end up being hurt, and if anything is added to the fish, the plants will be affected. How does this work? The waste from fish tanks is treated with natural bacteria that converts the waste, largely ammonia, first to nitrite and then nitrate. The fish waste absorbed by the plants is pumped to a biofilter system as a nutrient solution for growing plants. The only external input to the system is the food for the fish. Some disadvantages of aquaponics are: it can be expensive to set up, requires technical knowledge of aquaponics systems, roof crops cannot be grown on a large scale. If components fail, this could lead to great loss. In conclusion, agricultural production has evolved over the years, stemming from many ancient methods of agriculture. As world population increases rapidly, past farming methods cannot meet the world demand for food production. With the introduction of these advanced agricultural production techniques, farmers will benefit from the agribusiness on a larger scale because of faster production of produce and no more hindrances such as pest infestation and flooding.